Over millions of years, the Earth's surface shifted, forcing the Nile on a 300-mile detour to the east. It created what's known as the Great Bend. My plan is to walk all the way round. But because of a new dam, the army controls large parts of it. If we get too close to the Nile, we could be arrested, or even shot. It's the last thing I want, but we have to leave the river and walk right through the desert.
This is just going to be probably one of the hardest parts of the entire trip so far, because we're going to be going across a desert, part of the Sahara Desert, in the height of summer. Temperatures are just going to be ridiculously hot.
We're heading into the Bayuda volcanic field, where the temperatures regularly exceed 50 degrees Celsius. So we load up our camels with as much water as we can. 120 litres should last us 4 days. Awad and Ahmad assure me there are wells up ahead, but Moaz and I are walking 20 miles a day while they are riding. Our survival is in their hands. I've no choice but to trust them. After 3 days and 60 miles, we've not seen a single well.
And we're really trying to ration water, but I'm really thirsty now. So we've only got just over 24 hours worth of water left, so we really need to refill today, otherwise tomorrow we'll run out of water and it's at least 30-40 kilometres to the Nile now. It's a day's march without water, which is just unacceptable. There's no way we'd make that.
Awad and Ahmad believe there are wells up ahead, but they're working without maps. I'm dehydrated and starting to wonder if they know what they're doing.
This is horrific. We've done 40 kilometres, which is 25 miles, in the most horrific heat. Throat's completely parched.
Another 5 miles, and there's still no sign of a well.
It's times like this when I wonder what on earth.
We're 25 miles from the Nile, and down to our last drops of water. I'm starting to think we've made a massive mistake. 4 days ago, we took a detour from the banks of the Nile to avoid strictly controlled military installations. We're now 22 miles from the river and virtually out of water.
I've just lost the ability to speak. My mouth is so dry.
We need to find a well soon, but the nomads are drawing a blank. Just as I'm starting to lose all hope, a mirage comes into view.
Over there in the distance, that white thing, it's either a unicorn or a donkey.
Out of nowhere, some shepherds appear. I've heard about these guys. They're from the Manasir tribe. They herd livestock for hundreds of miles across this region and should know it better than anyone else. Now we just need to find it.
But it looks like they're running now. It looks like they're jogging, so they must have seen something. There it is. That is a deep well. There's no ropes. How do we get the water out? Well, I think we're safe. Boya!
Boya!
Woo! Woo! Cheers. Oh, that's good. I'm relying on these guys to keep us alive. But that was a close call. See how skinny his ribs are. The camels drink a whopping 30 litres of water each.
When he be really full, he will make the lifts again like this. You can see the ribs is gone. You see, it's fine now.
This water should last us until we reach the river. But the desert's not over with us yet.
There's a sandstorm coming, you can see it over there, so it's time to move on and get out of this canyon.
A sandstorm here is known as a haboob. They can reach 100 miles an hour and blind you if you're not careful.
Can't see a thing now. Where we're supposed to be going, all those mountains have just been completely wiped out by the sandstorm. Still hot, this is the amazing thing, even with this immense wind. Can't even see the camels now, they're over there somewhere.
If I lose the camels now, I'm in serious trouble. Luckily, they've stopped. And so has the haboob.